God has come to earth principally to speak his words. What you engage with is the word of God. What you see is the word of God. What you hear is the word of God. What you abide by is the word of God. What you experience is the word of God. And this incarnation of God principally uses the word to make man perfect. He does not show signs and wonders, and especially does not do the work Jesus did in the past. Although they are God and are both flesh, their ministries are not the same. When Jesus came, he also did part of God's work and spoke some words. But what was the main work he accomplished? What he mainly accomplished was the work of crucifixion. He became an image of sinful flesh to complete the work of crucifixion and redeem all mankind. And it was for the sake of all mankind's sin that he served as a sin offering. This is the main work he accomplished. Ultimately, he provided the path of the cross to guide those who came later. When Jesus came, it was primarily to complete the work of redemption. He redeemed all mankind and brought the gospel of the kingdom of heaven to man. And furthermore, he brought the kingdom of heaven. As a result, those who came after all said, "We should walk the path of the cross and sacrifice ourselves for the cross." Of course, in the beginning, Jesus also did some other work and spoke some words to make man repent and confess his sins. But his ministry was still the crucifixion. And the 3.5 years he spent preaching the way were in preparation for the crucifixion that came after. The several times that Jesus prayed were also for the sake of the crucifixion. The life of a normal man that he led and the 33.5 years that he lived on earth were primarily for the sake of completing the work of crucifixion. They were to give him strength and make him able to undertake this work, as a result of which God entrusted the work of crucifixion to him. Today, what work will God incarnate accomplish? Today, God has become flesh primarily in order to complete the work of the Word appearing in the flesh, to use the Word to make man perfect, and make man accept the dealing of the Word and the refinement of the Word. In his words, he causes you to gain provision and gain life. In his words, you see his work and deeds. God uses the word to chastise and refine you. And thus, if you suffer hardship, it is also because of the word of God. Today, God does not work using facts, but words. Only after his word has come upon you can the Holy Spirit work within you and cause you to suffer pain or feel sweetness. Only the Word of God can bring you into reality, and only the Word of God is capable of making you perfect. And so, at the very least, you must understand that the work done by God during the last days is principally the use of His Word to make every person perfect and guide man. All the work that he does is through the Word. He does not use facts to chastise you. There are times when some people resist God. God does not cause great discomfort for you. Your flesh is not chastised, nor do you suffer hardship. But as soon as his Word comes upon you and refines you, it is unbearable for you. Is that not so? At the time of the service doers, God said to throw man into a bottomless pit. Did man really arrive at the bottomless pit? Simply through the use of words to refine man, man entered into the bottomless pit. And so, during the last days, when God becomes flesh, He principally uses the Word to accomplish all and make all plain. Only in His words can you see what He is. Only in His words can you see that He is God Himself. When God incarnate comes to earth, He does no other work but the speaking of words. Thus, there is no need for facts. Words suffice. That is because He has principally come to do this work, to allow man to behold His power and supremacy in His words, to allow man to see in His words how He humbly hides Himself, and to allow man to know His entirety in His words. All that He has and is are in His words. His wisdom and wondrousness are in His words. In this are you made to see the many methods with which God speaks His words. Most of God's work during all this time has been provision, revelation, and dealing. He does not curse man lightly, and even when He does, it is through the Word. And so, in this age of God become flesh, do not try to see God heal and cast out demons again. Do not always try to see signs. There is no point. Those signs cannot make man perfect. To speak plainly, today, the real God Himself of the flesh only speaks and does not act. This is the truth. He uses words to make you perfect and uses words to feed and water you. He also uses words to work, and He uses words in place of facts to make you know His reality. If you are capable of perceiving this aspect of God's work, then it is difficult to be passive. Instead of focusing on things that are negative, you should focus only on that which is positive, which is to say, regardless of whether or not the words of God are fulfilled, or whether or not there is the advent of facts, God causes man to gain life from His words, and this is the greatest of all signs. And even more so, it is an undisputable fact. This is the best evidence through which to have knowledge of God, and is an even greater sign than signs. Only these words can make man perfect.